data-driven damage assessment using different metrics. Here is an example of cumulative absolute velocity, vision-based damage assessment. I'll talk more about that. And open hardware. We have been talking a lot about open software, OpenSeas, OpenFresco, open. How about open hardware? Can we also think of that? Can we have network of sensors that's accessible to the whole community? Maybe. Of course, security issues and so on. So we're working on some activities in that regard. Development of seismic performance observatory. Steve Mahan has started that. Gabriel here is behind this development, which basically is a database that has a structural information and damage database that I'll also say a few things about. So the whole background of this is wrapped around the so-called deep learning or machine learning, where basically you, if we take the computer vision or just using images as an example, of course this could be also for time series, this could be for acceleration measurements and so on. And if we have lots of images, and we do, unfortunately they are fragmented, you may have done reconnaissance work and you have a bunch of these in your computer that come from earthquakes or floods or hurricanes or typhoons or whatever. And if we manage to get expert opinion, like yourself, to tag these images, to tell us what are we seeing, right? And if we start building this library of tagged images, right, or labeled images, right, then we can use machine learning, like convolutional neural network or other methods, to classify these, what we see in these images, and then we have a smart algorithm that we can use to classify any other image. So then an event happens, you go, take your photos, you are not an expert, right? You are, but somebody else is not an expert. And then you upload this to SPO, SPO does its magic and does the classification for you. That can be very helpful in doing the reconnaissance in real time and also adding intelligence in the way we do the reconnaissance, for example. So we did a simple pilot study in the Mexico earthquake that happened in September, I think, where Jorge sitting back there. It's not a full experiment, but basically, can you take an image with your cell phone, upload it to SPO, and add information about this image? Structure information, what kind of building that is, what kind of framing, what damage are you seeing? And since these are professors and graduate students, so they have the knowledge to do the proper tagging or labeling of what they are seeing, and this information immediately go to the SPO, that then you can start assigning different tasks. Now, if you start building sufficient amount of labeled images, you can actually use that to solve a classification problem. And you can use your favorite algorithm, CNN or SVM or whatever classification you like. Here is an example of using convolutional neural network where we look at one of four tasks. What are we seeing? Beam, column, or a wall, or something else? So it's just a component classification. Is there spalling or no? These are easy, because these are just binary. Usually we do phenomenal job with this, 99% accuracy. Something ridiculous like that, right? But when you start having multiple decisions, these things get harder. For example, no cracks, hairline cracks, heavy cracks. Now you get into a little different. So you may get into the 95% accuracy or 90% accuracy. Then you start getting into no damage, flexural damage, shear damage, combined damage. Maybe you get into the 85-80% accuracy. The more the possibilities of the classification, the harder the algorithm will face. But the more images we have, right, because that's a well-known theory, the more images, labeled images we have, the higher the accuracy will be, even for a more challenging. And that's where we need your help. because this takes a community, not just to upload images, but to upload labeled images, right? And I'll tell you what to do with that. So I am not gonna go, I just mentioned one thing, is what we typically use for this is what's called transfer learning, meaning that, which is a way of cheating, but computer scientists found a nice name for cheating, which basically you take a network, right, with all its parameter and transfer it to another network. So for example, you could be classifying cats and dogs, right, and you transfer that to classifying flexure and shear cracks, if you find that these parameters will work, right? So you have a source domain and you have a target domain. The source domain can come from the so-called ImageNet. ImageNet is a network of images that have 14 million images at the moment, right? Of all sorts of things that computer scientists use for challenges, ImageNet challenge every year. So if we think of a structural ImageNet, right, which we will focus on these four classes that I just mentioned, or four tasks I mentioned, you can find lots of parameters that you have for this network that you can transfer to this network, at least as a starting point. But with more labeled images, you can perfect that and make it operational in an accurate way on other images. So at the moment, we only have, because this is only done with myself and a graduate student of mine, so just two people, right? So our bandwidth is very small compared to the bandwidth of a larger community. So we only have, at the moment, 2,000 images that are labeled well. And they are divided this way. This is how things broken down, of images that have been column or have wall, images that have no spalling, no damage, minor damage, moderate, and flexure, or the different types of damage. Right? And when you use these 2,000 images that are labeled, you get this accuracy, not surprising. When you test it, because we have actually 10,000 images, but only 2,000 of them labeled. When we try it on the other 8,000, it's not too bad, but start deteriorating when the task is harder. So what we are proposing to you is what we call the Peer Hub ImageNet, or the Greek letter phi. So this phi is going to be released in, I'll have the timeline at the end, which is a... So far, we have a demo version of a structure recognition tasks that gave promising results. The goal is to increase the number of labeled images. It will have a hierarchy tree that can be organized for structure health monitoring and post-disaster reconnaissance. It will be ImageNet-like, but it's a structure ImageNet-like, which will encourage further development of performance-based engineering. The ImageNet itself, as I said, it has 14 million annotated image database. We will have also an annual ImageNet that we will be holding starting from this year. Why this is useful? This is a part of the ImageNet. If you look in the computer science community, when they had this ImageNet challenge, the error that used to get is about 28% with more years. This is back in 2010. In 6 years, this error went down to 3% with increased number of participants. Of course, it was also increased number of images. So, and people in different fields, SpaceNet, MusicNet, Medical ImageNet, ShapeNet, EventNet, ActivityNet, how about Structure ImageNet? So that's what we are aiming for. Is also to have something focused on that. Last annual meeting, we have this blind prediction, which was an experiment we did in our shaking table. We're creating a similar one that's made of hybrid simulation. It was very successful in terms of participants, in terms of knowing the sources of uncertainty. So we are offering something similar, but focus on identifying these different features from images. We are aiming for 20,000 labeled images, tenfold what we have at the moment. The detection will be defined in this challenge. Basically, we will give you 20,000 labeled images, and then we'll give you some unlabeled images and tell you, identify this class or that class, right? And you use your best algorithm to do this challenge. So that's the goal of the challenge. But for this to happen, we need to provide you with a means to upload images. So if you go to this link, apps.peer.berkeley.edu/spo, you see some instruction for you here. If you have, you may need to sign up or sign in. If you don't have an account, it's free. You just fill in your email and whatnot. And then you hit the button that says upload image. That will take you to this location here, which basically you would need to hit create new image, which then will take you there. Then you would browse your own folders, right? Make sure you pick a maximum of 100 images that you can upload at once. The limit is 100, right?
Yes.
So then you can upload those, and then you fill in some information, who are you, and where did you get these images from, and so on. And then you save, then the images are in SPO. So what we are going to have is now the SPO site is ready for uploading images. What we are working on now is a tool that will help you to label your images or label somebody else's images. So that's still under development, but will be released fairly soon. It will be something like this, where it has the image. You will see what others have labeled this before. So there is like a guide. So you can follow what they have or decide that no, but they don't know what they are doing. So the way the labeling structure work is, it's identifying things related to the material. So this is on the pixel level, identifying things related to the components. So this is the object level, and identifying things related to the whole structure or the so-called system level. So I'm not going to go through the detail of this tree, but you can follow a certain path. There are several tasks, meaning that if there is damage, then it will tell you to classify the severity of the damage and so on. So you can easily follow that. So let's say level one or task one is, here is an image, and then you decide that this is an object. So you will hit the object, and then you go, you choose that this is the case. If there is a rebar here and you want to think of that on the pixel level, so you will go to this branch here because you want to say this is a rebar, and then basically this is where others have labeled this, and this is where your labeling gonna go in, right? So still this is a little bit under development. Then you go to the next task and so on, so that will take you through a series of tasks. At the end you have this summary which tell you this is an object, it's a wall, it is damaged, it has a spalling, it's a moderate damage, and it's a shear type damage, right? After going through these tasks, that's the end result that then you submit it, then this image have been labeled, right? So my last slide here is the timeline. So the announcement of this fee challenge have been released in the peer annual meeting in January 18. The new image collection start already up to end of May. We would like to receive your images. The labeling will start from the end of this month all the way to mid-July. Then we will prepare for the challenge, depending on did we achieve the 20,000 images, do they have sufficient classes that we can assign the challenge, and then we will receive your application to contribute or participate in the challenge so we can put you in the right bin. So basically we would look, are you a computer scientist or a structure engineer, or what kind of background you have, and then we will give you the task, and then you will work on it for about a month to do the classification. These are two independent things, so you can upload images and label them but never participate in the challenge, right? Or vice versa, or do both. So that's what we are planning to do. Why are we doing this? I like Alexander Gross. He was a physicist from Harvard, and he has this nice quote that says, data sets, not algorithms, might be the key limiting factor to development of human-level artificial intelligence. So the key is really to get as much data as we can. We're focusing now on images because it's easy, because there is the work of ImageNet that we can capitalize on. So we're starting with that, and maybe we move on to other type of data later on. So that's what I wanted to share with you, and hopefully it's not too boring, and hopefully we will get some response from the kind of images you have. Again, we're focusing on certain type of images, so please don't upload anything you haven't. So we're talking about structural components, so we're talking about damages, cracks, things like that. We may have another class that focus on equipment sliding or things like that. So at the moment, it is images that you probably have got from reconnaissance work you have done, from lab experiments you have done, so that sort of thing. So it's a structural image net, not any other type of image net. Thank you.